Hello friends, welcome to this Ganesh painting session. You must have noticed by now that this is a full imperial painting, and I have therefore taken it upon the easel. That is easier to paint large size paintings. I am just trying to give a wash. It's a mix of different yellows, yellow ochre, lemon yellow, cadmium, etc. The sketching part, I'm leaving it to you. You can do the sketching in case you want to try out this painting based on my finished painting, which I have displayed before the beginning, in the beginning of this video. So I have left some areas white, especially where there is this blue purple sapphire on the crown, so that I can paint it later. And I am trying to give the first wash. Some pinks also I have added, and now the orange at certain locations. The light is from the right hand side, about 2-3 o'clock direction. This is a crimson red. So generally speaking, the right side of this Ganesh painting will be lighter, and left side will be having dark tones. Darker tones rather, not really dark, but and this photograph or whatever has a garland around Ganapati's neck. And a blue cloth around. Now painting of the crown using this red brown and some raw umber. I am trying to do wet on wet at quite a few places. So that you get this beautiful watercolor effect, and which will make this painting look like a watercolor painting and not a photograph. These are part of the designs on the crown. Generally speaking, the designs are done using the browns and yellows with a touch up or the shadows of the design using dark brown. I used red brown color here. I have tried to do this loose painting. Actually, I enjoy this kind of a mixing up of different colors. Many a times there is a risk involved as to how they will merge with each other, but with some experience your risk reduces. So it becomes a calculated risk. Here I have painted around this white tooth and left the paper as it is, so as to highlight the tooth or the teeth on both the sides. And now the garland. Garland has primarily 3-4 shades: the red, the orange, the lemon yellow, cadmium yellow, and yellow ochre as well to a certain extent. So I have just tried to play with these colors, mix some of these colors wet on wet. So I have to give the impression of these marigold flowers garland. Here I have used ultramarine. For background, I have used dark brown, that is red brown, and the shade of grey and blacks. So actually, this dark tonal value makes this Ganesh stand out. So obviously, this becomes a focal point, and the face comes in the focus. Again, dark values for eyebrows, eyes, the hairline protruding out of the crown, and later on the bindi and some design on the trunk is using crimson red and pink colors. The most interesting part I find about this particular painting is the background as well as these garlands which are on using wet on wet.
Thank you.